Hi guys, Dr. J here, and in this video, we're going to talk about getting up and running with WebODM. And there's a couple of steps that are maybe a little bit tricky to sort of follow along with when you're doing this. So I just thought I'd make a quick video and talk about some of those. So first thing to do is to make sure that you have Docker running. So I'm on a Mac, but the process will be similar on a Windows computer. I'm just going to open Docker desktop. And so I'm going to open that. And you see nothing really has happened. And this is because Docker is actually running in a, kind of like a background app. So I'm going to come up here to my icons. And if you're on a Windows computer, sometimes these will be at the top, sometimes they'll be down in the bottom. But I will come up here, I'm going to click on the little ship icon. So you'll see the ship icon here. That means that Docker is running. And then I'm going to click on dashboard. Now, if Docker hadn't been running, this dashboard would probably have just come up right away. So it might depend on whether or not it's running or not in the background for you when you open it up. Either way, it's here and I've got my dashboard up now. And we need to do a few things before we run WebODM. Now, one thing you notice is that I already have a WebODM container running. I'm going to go ahead and delete that. I'm not actually running WebODM at the moment, but the container will still exist on my computer. So I'm going to delete that to make sure that I'm starting from a fresh environment. The other thing I'm going to do is come up here to settings. And I'm going to go to resources, and I'm going to make sure to allocate enough resources to my Docker desktop that my WebODM instance will be able to do the data processing that I'm asking it to do. So one quick note here is that it's possible on Windows computer that you won't see this resource allocation tab, and that's because on certain versions of Windows and WSL, there is automatic resource allocation. So if you don't see this, don't worry about it. Windows is automatically taking care of your resource allocation. I've got plenty of memory allocated, 28 gigabytes, and you'll want to make sure that you have at least 8 gigabytes of memory. And the more memory that you have, the larger jobs you'll be able to do. I've got 1 gigabyte of swap memory and 128 gigabytes of virtual disk space. So those numbers are okay for me. And again, the big one here is going to be the memory and the CPUs. So if you can allocate more CPUs, you don't necessarily want to allocate all your CPUs, but I've got 8 CPUs on this laptop, so I've allocated 4. And 28 gigabytes of memory out of 32 gigabytes total memory on my laptop. Again, you don't want to use all your memory on your laptop, the more that you can use, and again, you'll want to use at least 8 gigabytes, if at all possible, in order to do this processing. So I'm happy with these numbers, so I'm going to cancel this. And actually, I'm just going to go ahead and close the desktop right now for Docker. You don't have to have Docker open while Docker desktop is still running, because if I come up here to my system tray, there's my little boat icon, and I can see that Docker is still running. Now, I'm going to go to my terminal. If you're on a Windows machine, you'll probably be using Git Bash. So the Git Bash terminal, you would probably install that when you installed WebODM. And so I'm going to come to my regular terminal now. If you're on a Mac, you can just use your regular terminal. And I'm going to go to my software directory and WebODM. So now I'm in the WebODM directory. I've got all the Docker stuff in there and the WebODM stuff. I'm going to just now run webodm.sh start. It's going to do its thing. Give you a bunch of information. Now, if you're doing this on Windows for the very first time, it's going to take several minutes for you to get up and running. So basically, it's going to install a Linux virtual machine, and it's going to have a lot of programs associated with that, a lot of little software packages associated with that virtual machine. And so it's going to take probably a good 10, 15 minutes for that first start command to work for you if you're just doing this for the first time. Once you've done that, then that's installed and you should be good to go the next time around. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this localhost and I'm going to open a web browser. All right, so we've logged in and now you can see all the tasks and jobs that I've been running. For you, this will probably be mostly blank. It might say first project up there somewhere. But at this point, now we can start adding a new project. So we can go ahead and add a new project. I'm going to call this first project. Then I'm going to go here to select images and ground control points. So I'm going to grab all my imagery. I'm just going to open all that up. All right, so now we've selected 46 pictures. It's given it a name. It's using this particular processing node. This is just the WebODM default node. There's a number of options that you can use. So we've got the default option is going to be what I'm going to recommend that you start with. But there are a number of options here. We can do really high quality, high resolution, a fast orthophoto. So the orthophoto is the orthomosaic that we'll be creating in this example and in other examples. So if you just want that orthophoto, you don't need, for example, a digital surface model or a 3D point cloud. You just want to get the orthophoto as quickly as possible. That would be those options. DSM plus DTM, that's a digital surface model and digital terrain model. So with the vegetation and things removed, you have a forest, buildings, different options, multispectral there, different options, and it will select the options from all possible options that are best for that particular preset. You can change all the options yourself manually by clicking on edit. And you can see here, there's actually quite a few different options to look at. I'm not going to change any of those because we're just going to use the regular default thing. So sometime you can check out these different options, but we're not going to go through them in this video. We'll do that maybe another time. There's also a resize option. And again, if you're just starting out, I suggest that you go ahead and do the resizing. This is going to reduce the resolution of your photos if you're using very high quality imagery. So for example, if you have a DJI P1, this is probably going to reduce the quality of your photos. But it's going to make your processing faster because it's going to resize all your images to this smaller size, and that's going to make the processing go faster. So again, there's a trade-off here between processing speed and quality of imagery. If you're just getting started, I recommend doing the resizing so that you can process as quickly as possible and just make sure that everything is working. I'm going to click review and start processing. And so we're going to the basic process that WebODM is going to walk through is it's going to upload the images first. Then you can see it's going to resize the images. Here's our 46 pictures that we've uploaded. I can click on this little button here just to sort of see what's going on. And it's got some information here, kind of a summary of information. It's going to do these different things. You can also click on task output, and that's going to give you some kind of an indication of what are the current tasks that are running in WebODM. So there we go. It just finished resizing and it's starting to process. So now you can see here is some information about all the different things that's happening. So there's some of the metadata. And now it's reading data, extracting data, found many different points. This is just kind of an output of the actual code that's running on your particular processing routine. So I'm going to turn that off for the moment. You can also cancel the job or delete the job while it's running. So if something gets stuck or it's taking too long, these 46 images might take 20, 30 minutes to run on my Mac laptop. So I recently ran 12 or 1300 photos on a Windows laptop, and that took about 2 days of processing, and it processed them all through, went just fine. It just took a little bit of time. So just keep that in mind when you're doing your processing. For 46 photos, it's not going to be a problem. It'll be done in 20, 30 minutes at most. But if you have a lot of photos, it's going to take some time. And that's also where your resources comes into play, where the software can use more resources. It can get the processing done a little bit faster. Okay, so at this point, we're just waiting. Once it's finished, then we'll see the outputs down here at the bottom. Okay, so now WebODM is finished processing. We've completed. And now we've got some options down here at the bottom. So I'll first show you we can download our assets. This includes the orthophoto, a surface model. Some of this, these things will not be available depending on your options that you selected. But because we had the default options, you have all these different options here. And of course, you can download all the assets together. Let's go ahead and take a look at the orthomosaic. Here we go. Here's our orthomosaic. This was a oblique imagery orthomosaic that was focused on doing 3D modeling. So let's jump right over to the 3D model. And again, we're here in the WebODM interface. I'll zoom in a little bit. This was a little gazebo type thing. And there's actually a tree here, which didn't really get picked up well. This is a pretty common thing for photogrammetry, where small, thin items like wires and tree branches without leaves, those are not going to get picked up well by the imagery. We can show a textured model in WebODM. All right, so now we have our products and assets from WebODM. We'll talk in another video about what you can do with these post-processing.